Hello YouTube. Today I watched the Red Pill documentary, finally. And here's my review. I assume that you have some idea what the Red Pill movie is about. And you've probably even heard about some of the backlash that it has received. But here in short, the Red Pill documentary is about the men's rights movement and the issues that men face in today's society, in today's world. And the backlash has come from Australia and colleges that won't show the Red Pill movie, documentary, and I think it was even some movie theater in America that wouldn't show the documentary. And after I knew that it wasn't anything horrible, this documentary, but now seeing it, what's wrong with some Australians and feminists? I have no idea what goes inside those heads. It must be an amazing place in a really weird way and a horrible, terrifying way. The documentary was made by a former feminist, Cassie J. And she was a feminist when she started this documentary, making this. And then she, I guess she saw the light or something, and she doesn't call herself a feminist anymore. She got red-pilled. So the documentary touches upon things as family courts, domestic violence, especially from male perspective, false paternity and paternity fraud, then male deaths in work and in wars, stuff like that. I like how this documentary isn't just, you know, men have these and these things that affect them, but hey, let's take a look at what women go through, or some women go through. And this documentary really focuses on those things. And I understand the backlash that this documentary has gotten because... And I understand the backlash this documentary has gotten because a lot of people see men's rights advocates as these losers and misogynists and women haters that don't have any real issues. But this documentary shows that the things that men's rights advocates are trying to bring awareness and change things. And you know, I might be a bit biased because I call myself an MRA. I see myself as an MRA. And I do want to bring awareness to some things. And if this documentary doesn't red pill many feminists, then you know, nothing will, probably. And I don't know if Cassie J did this on purpose, but all the feminists in this documentary look like, well, kind of stupid and biased as well. Especially what MRAs are talking about, and then they tell their side of the story, the feminist side. And I do think that many feminists and people overall agree a lot of with men's rights advocates, but they are afraid of calling themselves that. Overall, this was an excellent documentary, and it touched upon and focused on many things that men face. But now, later, think about the documentary, and something that I have done somewhat in my channel is showing these false rape accusations. And this documentary, of course, it was 1 hour 57 minutes overall, so you can't touch upon everything, but it didn't go into the false rape accusations that much. So that's The only thing that I wish their Cassie could have done more, but and still it was an excellent documentary. And now every time a feminist is trying to say something about men's rights, you can point her to this documentary and say, go watch that and then come back. I think The Red Pill, 9.5 out of 10. It's just really good. I do wonder that when or if these feminists who are in the documentary, when they see it, do they change their mind or not? I doubt that they will change their mind. But the Red Pill documentary has done its part. So if they don't change their mind, they are long gone. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye.